Hola amigos y amigos, bienvenidos a RBC Internacional. Les saluda Mara Carranza, gracias a los administradores de este canal y su fundador, Ricardo Belmont Casinelli. Hoy les voy a traducir a inglés la mañanera del presidente de México, Andrés Manuel López Obrador. Y hoy habló sobre el caso de la investigación del caso de La Barron, de la familia La Barron, y también de los casos de derechos humanos, cosas así. Oh. Hello friends, and welcome to RBC International. My name is Mara Carranza from AMLO Vision and English AMLO Vision, and I am here thanks to the invitation of the administrators of this channel and its founder, Ricardo Belmont Casinelli. Today, I am going to be translating the morning conference of the Mexican president. His name is Andrés Manuel López Obrador. Today, they were dealing with the in-depth investigation and clarification of the case of La Barron, and also discussing different areas of human rights. Thank you very much, and the video translation will follow. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. So right here, this newspaper person or journalist is going to ask the president or ask the president a question. So let's go ahead and hear it.
¿Y cómo será con ellos? ¿Se abrirá un diálogo? ¿Se abrirá el diálogo hacia la delincuencia organizada?
So here he asks the president, are you going to open up the dialogue? How are you going to convince organized crime to start doing right, to lower the indexes of crime?
Esa es una pregunta.
And that was one of his questions.
La otra es, ¿cómo trabaja la inteligencia en este sentido de trabajar con los generadores de la violencia?
And then it also asks, how does the intelligence department work to work with these generators of violence?
Tal vez el pueblo, todos los demás estemos de acuerdo en bajar estos índices, pero ellos, ¿qué irán a hacer?
So he says, perhaps the whole town, all of Mexico, is, or all the people of Mexico, are willing to lower the index of crime. But if the organized crime people aren't willing, how are you going to convince them?
Ustedes, ¿cómo lo irán a tratar?
Bueno, entendí la primera pregunta. Nosotros.
So here the president says he understood the first question and he's going to start with that.
Nosotros tenemos una estrategia, ayer se expuso.
And he says we have a strategy and I exposed it yesterday.
Para garantizar la paz.
In order to guarantee peace.
Repito, consiste primero en garantizar el bienestar de la población.
And he says, first you have to guarantee well-being for the population.
Incluye el que no haya corrupción.
And this includes that there not be any corruption.
Que no se asocie la autoridad con la delincuencia.
And he says, the authorities should not be in association with delinquents.
Que actuemos de manera coordinada.
That we behave in a coordinated manner.
Todos los que tenemos responsabilidad.
All of us that have responsibility.
En garantizar la paz.
In guaranteeing peace.
Que se atienda el problema de manera permanente.
And to attend the matter in a permanent way.
Como lo hacemos.
As we are doing.
Todos los días.
Every day.
Que se busque más presencia de agentes de la Guardia Nacional.
That we look for more presence from the National Guard.
en el territorio, que se combata el consumo de drogas.
And to combat the consumption of drugs.
Para eso la campaña contra las adicciones.
And that's why we have a campaign against addictions.
Y que se fortalezcan valores.
And that we fortify values.
En lo cultural, en lo moral, en lo espiritual.
In the cultural, moral, and spiritual.
Todo esto es parte de nuestra estrategia.
All of this is part of our strategy.
Otra cosa importante también.
Another important thing.
Es que no haya impunidad.
Is that there not be any impunity.
Que no se permita a nadie violar la ley.
That nobody be permitted to violate the law.
Aplicar la máxima de los liberales de que al margen de la ley nada y por encima de la ley nadie.
And that they will apply the law and nobody is above the law or above the law or over the law.
Desde luego, esta estrategia no pone por delante el uso de la fuerza.
But this does not put ahead of itself the use of force or at its front.
Consideramos que no debe de enfrentarse la violencia con la violencia.
We consider that violence should not be confronted with violence. Okay, so this was a very important part of the meeting. There was so many. I have a very hard time when I have to do these short ones because I have to decide what is important. And I hate to do that because it seems like everything's important. So let's try this.
Sobre todo atendiendo las causas que originan la violencia.
And here he says, above all, we have to attend to the causes that originate violence.
Problemas de desintegración familiar.
The disintegration of family.
Falta de oportunidades.
Lack of opportunities.
De trabajo.
Work.
Desatención a los jóvenes.
No attention to the youth. Or lack of attention to.
Consumismo. O lujos baratos. Frivolidades.
Cheap luxuries, frivolities.
Estilos de vida. En donde lo importante es lo material.
A style of life where what is important is what's material.
Todo eso, pues es lo que estamos haciendo y.
All of this is what we are doing and.
Gobernando con el ejemplo.
And we govern by example.
Creo que ayuda mucho.
I believe this helps very much.
Es una serie de acciones.
It's a series of actions. But you know, this really is very much how he has been changing the life in Mexico. Not only has he added many different things to help the society, such as jobs, education, youth programs, apprentice programs for those that are past the college or high school age. And he said, either they will be working, you know, regarding the youth, either they will be working or they will be getting an education. Those are their two choices. Because he wants them to have opportunities, and he does not want them to turn to violence. Another thing he says is that he's just trying to close off all the doors to organized crime in a way that they will be shut out from society, and they will have to dwindle away because they will have nobody to increase their growth or fortify them. That is said somewhere further. Let's see.
Ninis.
And this is where he's talking about how they coined the phrase ninis. Ninis was a phrase that they coined saying, neither do they work, neither do they have a job. I'm sorry, do they go to school? So he said they just coined the phrase, but they did nothing about it. So, of course, the youth had no choices, no options. Most of them weren't even allowed to go to school because they did it like with a, basically, it was done where people who knew somebody or had friends in high places could get an education, and it was very few, and they would have a very rigorous exam, and they set the bar very high, like you'd have to get 125 out of 125, for those that did not have the finances, and then very high number, might be even 122 or 123, or if you got 122, you didn't make it. So they just had a very high number of students that wanted to study all these professions that didn't get a chance because of they were trying to make privatized education. So only the ones that could afford it could go to school. So he changed that and made it so that everyone can get an education. Not only that, but he gives them grants so that while they're going to school, all the students, every level, have grants so that they can have the necessities of life, which might be, you know, just food, shelter, books, whatever they need. And so if there's multiple youth in the home, and or even if they're on their own, they can support themselves while they finish their education. So here's another part. This is where he's talking about that.
Eso fue lo que hicieron, acuñar esa frase.
So here he said all they did was coin that phrase.
Se repetía eso.
And they used to repeat it over and over again.
Nunca se hizo nada por los jóvenes.
And they never did anything to help the youth.
Además, que no hubo en el periodo neoliberal un éxodo.
And he said, wasn't there a mass exodus in the neoliberal period?
Miles de mexicanos.
Thousands of Mexicans.
Se fueron al exilio.
Went into exile.
Porque no tuvieron oportunidad de salir adelante en el país.
Because they had no opportunities to get ahead in their countries or in their country.
Que no se despobló el campo. Que no se desintegraron las familias.
Did they not get rid of our field work? Did they not disintegrate the families?
Por esa política de abandono al
due to that politics that abandoned
campo,
the fields, the field work, the crops.
Entonces pues estamos pagando las consecuencias.
So now we are paying the consequences.
Y tenemos que modificar ya esa política.
And now we have to modify that type of politics.
Desde luego, hay quienes tienen una visión distinta.
Of course, there are those that have a different vision.
Y respetamos ese punto de vista.
And we do respect that point of view.
Nada más.
However,
que el uso de la fuerza
that you support,
la guerra
and war,
ya demostró,
has already demonstrated,
que no es opción.
That it is not
resultó un fracaso.
It turned out to be a total failure.
En vez de resolver el problema, lo agravó.
And instead of resolving the problem,
entonces, regresar a eso,
it aggravated it.
No.
So he said, return to that? No.
La guerra, no.
Not war.
Tenemos que resolver el problema como lo estamos haciendo.
We have to
resolve, claro, lleva tiempo, pero tenemos confianza.
He says we have to resolve the problem the way we are doing it, and of course it's going to take time, but we are confident
de que vamos a poder avanzar.
That we will be able to advance in this purpose.
Ah, okay. Ya nos vamos para la izquierda.
So now he's going to the left.
Los dos.
Señor presidente, dos temas, por favor. Arturo Páramo, Grupo Imagen. Primero, respecto a lo que está sucediendo todavía ayer en Ciudad Juárez, después del capítulo en el que se intentó tomar el orden en el penal de esa ciudad, ayer todavía continuaron las quemas de autobuses y asesinatos.
So he said yesterday they tried to take over the penal system or the, I guess, a prison. And they were still burning buses there.
En esa ciudad. Entiendo que es el Cártel del Pacífico. Quisiera saber cuál es lo que está haciendo el gobierno.
And he wants to know what the government's doing about it.
Y un poco como lo que comentaba mi compañero, ¿qué tanto se está haciendo de inteligencia para poder desactivar a estos cárteles?
And what are they doing with intelligence regarding deactivating these cartels?
Y sobre el mismo tema, es el asunto del senador de Estados Unidos, Chip Roy, que ayer insistió en...
And yesterday they said that the senator from the U.S., Chip Roy, insisted on... I'm going to translate. I already heard this part. He asked, they offered to help us to make it a state of emergency, and then they would be able to help, to make them... terrorist acts, the criminal behavior to make it terrorist acts, and then they could come help us if we requested it.
Que se catalogue a los cárteles por parte del gobierno de Estados Unidos como organizaciones terroristas.
Aunque la vida pública tiene que ser cada vez más pública, hay ciertas cosas.
So here he told them that they do have intelligence working on them. They are doing very well. They are not requesting the help of the United States. They've got it under control, and they are a sovereign country, and they appreciate President Donald Trump's offer to assist, and he was very cordial, he said, and he was not pushy, and he just offered his help should he require it, and he was thankful for that. Okay, let's go to the next part.
Una postura acorde con nuestros principios constitucionales, y eso es lo que estamos haciendo, sin balandronadas, solo recordar que somos un país libre, independiente y soberano.
So this is where he was saying that they are a country that's free and sovereign.
Que somos respetuosos por lo mismo.
And that we are respectful for the same reason to any of the situations that happen in the United States, not to get involved. Okay, so next question. Let's go to the next question.
Están teniendo menos gasto.
Pues tengo otro dato.
Okay.
Este,
here, this man said that there was a 0.3% loss in the purchasing power or something like that. And he said, well, I have other data on that.
Abajo, el pueblo.
At the base where the people are.
Tiene, afortunadamente, recursos.
Fortunately, now they have financial resources.
Desde luego que hay pobreza.
But of course, there still is poverty.
Muchas necesidades.
Lots of necessities.
Pero.
However.
Ahora hay más dinero circulando.
Now we have more money circulating.
Bajo que antes.
At the bottom than before.
Y eso lo puedo probar.
And he said, and I can prove this.
Primero porque
first,
because se están dispersando fondos,
we are dispersing funds
en beneficio de los pobres, como no se hacía antes.
Because
este año, repito, se van a destinar 300 mil millones de pesos.
This year we're going to destine 300,000 million pesos.
Imagínense lo que es.
Imagine what that is.
Destinar 125 mil millones de pesos.
We destine 125,000 million
para adultos mayores.
Pensions for older adults.
O 20 mil millones para,
and he's got 20
200 mil sembradores
for 20,000
del sureste,
for the south,
nada más en Chiapas,
not just in Chiapas. Now there was also something that the president said regarding this elder adults money, is that he is going to be putting in a request he's going to be writing a new law, a request for new laws to be made to make it a something that they have to have, that they cannot take away the funds from elder adults and education. So I think this is coming up.
Donde en las rancherías, en los pueblos.
Okay, let me see.
Por eso digo, tengo otros datos.
So he has spent, given a lot of money to the people. There's 900,000 youth that are working in the program as apprentices, and they get paid about $5,000 a month, I think it is. And then there's several other programs that people are getting paid lots of money, you know, compared to what they used to get. And so he knows that there's the economy is doing much better because people have money to spend now. And he said something else about that. Let me see.
El Banco de México para que bajen las tasas de interés. Entonces, toda esa información del INEGI a la que hace referencia, ayuda a entender lo que está sucediendo. Es muy importante.
So he says that all the information that INEGI gives, which is the one that he was using to say that it has something to do with you know, the lowering of the interest rates or the spending rates, but he says this is beneficial for some purposes, but they don't have all the data, or they're not taking everything into account that has stimulated the economy.
Destacar, pues, todos los datos.
They have to have all the data, not just one area.
Imagínense.
Imagine
la importancia que tiene.
The importance that it has.
De que no tengamos un problema de inflación.
Imagine we have no inflation. Not that problem.
la importancia que tiene
and the importance of
que el peso
that the peso
no se deprecie
is not depreciating
la importancia que tiene que se estén creando empleos
that we're creating jobs
la importancia que tiene
the importance of
que esté aumentando el salario
that salaries are going up
pero bueno
but of course
tenemos nosotros la obligación de informar
but we have the obligation to inform
y de contestar todas las preguntas
and to ask all answer all the questions
nuestra obligación
and that is our obligation
qué bueno que tenemos esta oportunidad ahora sí nos vamos a la izquierda
now he's going to go to the other side but let's see what the next question is
víctimas y esto pues se toma en consideración y todo lo que pueda ayudar a esclarecer los hechos todas las hipótesis pero ese es un equipo especial profesional que está a cargo de esta investigación
segunda pregunta presidente
okay, I'm sorry, I better go back on that
recogiendo información
dando la violencia para crear un mayor conflicto dentro del gobierno que usted encabeza o bueno porque ya se han manejado diferentes hipótesis sé que hay una investigación bueno se ha anunciado aquí ha estado el gabinete y se ha dado esa información pero bueno en este sentido y en este contexto Culiacán y lo más reciente el tema de Levarón que ha causado bastante conmoción en la sociedad hay esa posibilidad que sea un mensaje incluso directo al gobierno y ahorita le hago una segunda pregunta
bueno hay un equipo que se ha integrado para la investigación
so they were asking that is there someone who's trying to undermine his government and that do they think that LeBaron case and the other cases that have been happening like in Culiacán are they things that are being brought forth by people that are trying to undermine his government and he says he does have a team that's working on that investigation
para indagar los hechos
they're going to dig into the facts
desde luego para hacer justicia
and they're going to cause there to be justice
y están manejando todas las hipótesis
and they're managing all the hypotheses
todas no se descarta nada
and they do not let anything go
pero están trabajando
but they are working on it
y recogiendo información sea lo que se refiere fue una declaración creo que ayer de uno de los familiares de las víctimas y esto pues se toma en consideración y todo lo que pueda ayudar a esclarecer los hechos
so he says they're doing everything they can to clarify what happened or the occurrence and they're talking about the Levarón case so thank you very much for watching ladies and gentlemen I hope you enjoyed our presentation of English AMLOvision translating the Mexican President Andrés Manuel López Obrador his conference in the morning for the channel RBC International and we would like to remind you that Mr. Ricardo Belmont Casanelli has a couple of books and they are available on Amazon so here's one This one is very good. It gives you little bits and pieces of thoughts for the day. It's almost like a proverbs, little thoughts for the day. And it's Pastillas para levantar el moral. And the other one is this one here, Los Once Días del Perú. And that is also a very interesting book. Hope you enjoy them.
Bye.